Master Corner. I'm your host, Noah Pitzer, and this is my 8th and final time going to summer camp, so I thought I'd bestow as much knowledge upon you as possible with a basic packing video. Now, I might choose to make a little extras slash luxury items video a little bit later if you guys would like to see something like that, just a few other ideas of stuff that you could bring. But one thing that I must stress is to not overpack your trunk throughout this entire packing process. I know that just because there's room in your trunk, you might want to bring more stuff, but that actually makes it a lot harder to clean up your stuff and put it all back when it comes to leaving camp. So we're going to go ahead and just start off with the trunk and then move all the way through down to the clothes at the end right here. Now, like I said, this is the basics. So if you don't see something that you like to bring, that doesn't mean that you shouldn't or can't bring it. This is just going to be the stuff that is really necessary to bring to summer camp. So I'm going to go ahead, like I said, and start with the trunk. Now, this one right here is the Plano trunk footlocker thing, I guess. There's no real right or wrong way to do this. However, we do like to see two different types of trunks. There's this one from Plano. This is pretty popular. And then there's another kind that I kind of forget about. It's a little bit smaller. I don't exactly know the name of it, but there's a picture of it right here for you guys to check out. And there'll be a link to it in the description below along with this one. Now, there's no problem, like I said, if you want to bring a different type of trunk. It's just going to be a lot easier to pack onto the U-Haul if you have these two types of trunks because, of course, it'll make the puzzle of fitting all the trunks onto the U-Haul pretty effortless. So, one thing that you need to know about the trunk is to put your name on all sides of it. Make it recognizable. I've seen people put duct tape right all over it. Sharpies put a bunch of stickers all over it. I just put my name, Troop, and I put it on pretty much all sides. You guys can see right here. It's on the back there as well. It's kind of hard to see. But it's pretty good idea to do that. So you guys can see we open it up. This one has four latches and it has multiple spots for a lock if you desire. And yeah, it's pretty nice way to carry all your stuff so it doesn't get smashed if you have a duffel bag. So make sure you get a hard trunk. Now let's go ahead and walk through all the things you need to wear on your way to camp. And just like other campouts, we're going to be wearing a Class A uniform while we travel, and then also at dinner and at the closing and opening campfires. So just make sure that you always have your Class A with you no matter what. And now we're going to talk about, like I said, what we're going to be wearing. So I always recommend to wear waterproof boots. These will be your primary footwear that you're going to start wearing on the day of arrival at the parking lot and at summer camp. So make sure that they're waterproof boots. Otherwise, you might want to bring two other pairs of shoes rather than just one, because if we have a particularly wet year at summer camp, you're going to be in a pretty tough situation if your shoes are always wet, and that's no fun. So we're going to be wearing the Class A, of course, and then you always want to bring a watch with you, so start wearing your watch now. This one's a pretty simple, just digital watch that, you know, of course, says the time and the date, has timer, alarms, stuff like that. This is all you need just because you are responsible for making sure you get to your classes on time and that you wake up on time as well. So yeah, you always want to have a watch, even if you've never worn a watch before or don't really wear a watch usually, make sure you pick one up for summer camp. Now, of course, you're going to need your Class B uniform as well, and that's going to go under your Class A so that you can take it off before you get too hot and sweaty when you're setting up on the Sunday that we arrive. So yeah, that's everything that you're going to need to be wearing on the way there. And then here is the day pack. Now, this is kind of a preference for me of everything that I like to carry in my day pack, but you guys can, you know, take a few things out or choose what you want to wear. But basically, we're going to start off with the actual pack itself. This one's not very big. This one's an REI Flash 18, but any school backpack or anything like that would honestly even be better because it can carry some more stuff. So I always like to have my swimsuit and towel with me. That's just a personal preference thing. Some people don't mind running back to camp, but I like to have it just in case I go swimming with my friends after dinner one night. It's always convenient to have just because, of course, out of the blue plans can change, and then you don't want to always have to be hindered by going all the way back to camp. And that's the same with the Class A. I always keep my Class A in my bag just because, like I said, at dinner and at the campfires, you're going to need it. So Every single year, we always have scouts running back to camp to grab their Class A. And that's really not that much fun for you because you have to run all the way back there and also hold the rest of the troop up. So always have your Class A with you, and it's optional to have your swimsuit and towel with you as well. Now, I always like to carry my hat with me. When it's not on my head, it's always in my bag, as well as sunglasses. It just makes sure that I don't get any sunburns on my face or anything like that. So there you go. That's personal preference as well. And then always carry a flashlight with you if possible, especially when we're going to campfires and stuff like that. Just because, of course, you need to keep it when the sun goes down. You're not going to be able to find your way back to camp very easily, especially if you're going through the woods. Now, you can keep a knife with you. Make sure you have your totem chip. If you don't have your totem chip, put your knife in your trunk. And if there's plenty of opportunities, I think Trailblazer has an opportunity to get your fireman chip and your totem chip at summer camp as well. So I always keep a deck of cards, and this is a nice little one of those folding frisbee things with me. These are just entertainment, and if I stop by the trading post, we can always get a game of cards going. So that's nice to have with me as well. And then, of course, we need to have our personal first aid kit at all times. We need to be prepared, so we just got the essentials in here. I also keep my sunscreen in here, which is also very important as well. Now, of course, you're going to need your water bottle to keep with your day pack at all times. One thing that's super important during summer camp is to be drinking a bunch of water, of course. So make sure that you always have it with you and it's always filled up. There's plenty of spigots and opportunities to fill up your water bottle at summer camp. Now we're going to talk about our rain gear. I have a big bag with my rain poncho and my rain jacket and, I guess, pants. So you don't need to bring this entire thing. Make sure that you always have some sort of poncho with you, just in case it decides to rain, because you obviously don't want to have to go all the way back to camp and get it out of your trunk if you need to get your rain jacket. So you don't necessarily need the full suit, but it's nice to have. So now the last thing I like to carry with me, and just because I have it, this is my FlexLite chair from REI. It's a nice little camp chair that fits nicely in this REI bag. So you know, it's kind of personal preference, like I said, and most people like to go for the big camp chairs. I wouldn't recommend coming without one of those chairs just because it's nice for comfort back at camp. But if you have something small like this or a little stool, it's nice if it fits in your bag because you can take it with you and sit down when you're tired. So now we're going to move on to the bedding and other items that kind of go in your trunk. Again, this is the basics. So if you guys would like something else to put in your tent or anything like that, you can, of course, do that as well. So first off is a fitted sheet. Now this is the fitted sheet that I've used exclusively for summer camp my past 7 times, and will use it for the final time here in my 8th year of summer camp. And it's really nice because the beds are, you know, pretty dirty when you get there, just because, of course, they've been sitting out in the wild for a few weeks. So, you know, what should a mattress be like, of course? And then if I always bring my little pillow. This is an inflatable pillow. It's, of course, not really necessary, especially if you're bringing a full bed pillow with you. But it's nice for added support, as well as, of course, the full bed pillow. And I have a little airplane travel pillow thing. I like my pillows, I guess. But if you guys just make sure to bring one full-size pillow. That's what people prefer, or some sort of pillow or anything to use in general. Now, in terms of sleeping bags, I know a lot of people use the 35 degree range of sleeping bags to bring to summer camp. That's totally fine. Even if you have something lighter, I like to use a fleece sleeping bag and an extra blanket. That's just my personal tried and true method of staying warm during summer camp, because of course you don't need that much insulation, but of course make sure to bring a good sleeping bag with you. It's always good to be too warm rather than too cold. So yeah, keep that in mind. Now we're going to move on to the back corner here, where we're going to be talking about the different other items that I keep with me in my trunk. So I always have an extra flashlight of some sort, and this one's like a tripod flashlight thing. It's kind of nice. But you should probably have some sort of headlamp with you as well. That makes it a lot more convenient. Then since I wear contacts, I always have an extra pair of glasses with me. So if you wear contacts or you have glasses, make sure to either bring an extra pair of glasses or have extra contacts available. This is nice because in the middle of the night, if I wake up or there's like an emergency, I can just pop these on and I don't have to worry about fiddling with my contacts for 5 minutes or so. So now we're gonna talk about these lights. These are actually IKEA lights that are battery-powered Christmas lights. So you guys can see, turn them right on. And these are kind of popular for hanging your tent. It's kind of like, you know, setting in the lights in the ceiling, you know, nice and convenient. Don't have to have a flashlight in your tent in the middle of the night. You can illuminate the full tent. This one was about $3 at IKEA. So, you know, what could really go wrong? So now we've got a fan right here. Now this one is one of those O2 Cool fans that I really recommend. They're powered by like 4D batteries. They're pretty heavy, but they work really well for keeping you cool at night. The next thing is an extra water bottle. This is extremely important. If you forget everything else, do not forget this, because you must stay hydrated. If you forget your water bottle somewhere, you lose it. You want to make sure you have an extra, because you can't just stop drinking water. Now, I have my personal hygiene kit here as well. And when I take it to the shower, I also take my towel for my day pack. We've got deodorant, my contacts, my comb, my toothbrush and toothpaste, as well as shampoo and soap for the shower in there. So make sure you have all of those things if you need them. And then I always like to bring some extra shopping bags with me, just for convenience. If I have a wet swimming suit, or I have a, you know, something else that needs to be contained, like dirty laundry, this is a good place to use those. So always have a few extra of those laying around with you. Now, these are my shower shoes. They're basically just slides. They're good for, you know, obviously wearing the shower where it's dirty, and also getting up in the middle of the night if you need to just slide something on. I usually go for these, but you can obviously just use your other shoes as well. So some cheap flip-flops or something like that should work fine. Now we're going to talk about clothes, and before I do, I'll just go ahead and mention that I'm bringing athletic shoes as my second pair of shoes, just because if I want to do something more fitness related, such as if you're doing a personal fitness merit badge or something where you'll be running around a lot, you might prefer these over your hiking boots. So now let's talk about, like I said, the clothes. I'm bringing 6 Class B t-shirts with me, one for each day, and pretty simple. So, you know, just bring 6 of those. And then, of course, along with the one pair of pants that's over there, I'm gonna be bringing 2 extra pairs of scout pants and 1 pair of athletic shorts for sleeping in. So that's kind of personal preference, but make sure at least one of those has pants attached to it, just because you want to make sure that you have that option if there's a lot of thick grass that you don't want to get like ticks or anything on your legs, or if it's cold for some reason. I don't really think it will be, but that's always a good option to be prepared for. Now, so along with 3 pairs of shorts, it's also good to have a hoodie of some sort, just for insulation purposes, of course, if it gets cold during the night. And then I bring 6 pairs of socks, 6 pairs of underwear. It's pretty self-explanatory. Make sure, try to bring like wool socks or something like that. They can wick away your sweat and dry quickly. And then in terms of storing all this stuff, a lot of people like to go for like the 2-gallon Ziploc bags, and I'm all for that. But I like to use, personally, I like to use these bigger waterproof bags. Just that's what I've used for a long time. But the nice thing about the Ziploc 2-gallon bags is that you can organize them by day. So if you want to say, I'm going to wear this shirt, these socks, this underwear, and these pants for one day, that's cool. Or you can organize them by category, of course, as well as they're clear. So one thing that these don't do is you can't really see them from the side and grab at what you're looking at from the side of the bag. So yeah, that's just a good idea altogether. Make sure that you stay organized. And if anything, try to keep them in a waterproof type of bag, like a Ziploc bag, so that you don't have any wet clothes just sitting there in your trunk. Alright, so this should all pack up into your trunk pretty nicely. So if you have any questions, just let me know. This is pretty much everything that you're going to need to survive at summer camp. Make sure, do not forget a scout book and all your requirement stuff. But in terms of gear and clothes, this is what you're going to need. So if you have any questions, make sure again to let me know. Let any of the older scouts know who have done this before, and they'd be happy to help you out and help you decide what to bring. So thank you guys for watching. If you have any more Quartermaster Corner suggestions, let me know, and I will get back to you as soon as I can. So see you guys later.